when it comes to spending hard-earned taxpayer money in Canada, paying million-dollar security bills for runaway members of the British royal family should not be a government priority. Just down the street, right behind me, is the house where the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, are rumored to have made their temporary residence. It's a beautiful multi-million-dollar mansion on the water here on the outskirts of Greater Victoria. And it's part of their plan to hang up their skates from royal duties, move away from the United Kingdom, and become financially independent. Which is fine, except for one minor problem. They're still planning on leaving taxpayers with an annual security bill of up to $1.7 million, a large portion of which, apparently, may end up falling on the backs of Canadian taxpayers. The truth is, none of this makes any sense. For one thing, the prince isn't here in any official capacity. He's not representing the government, fulfilling a role, or conducting work on behalf of taxpayers of any kind. And even more importantly, he and his family are already rich, like hundreds of millions of dollars. And yet now we're expected to divert money away from things like healthcare and education to support him when he doesn't even have a job. It would be like moving out of your grandmother's house at age 35 to live with your cousin and expecting him to foot all your bills. That is, if your grandmother happened to be the queen. Now, to be clear, I actually support the royal family. What I don't support is someone getting access to taxpayers' money for not doing any work. In any case, while I'm sure we all welcome the prince, his wife Meghan, and son Archie to this country with open arms, when it comes to spending our hard-earned taxpayer dollars, we need to do better than this.